Welcome friends, let us go for the next part of the carbon family, that is silicates. Silicates are metal derivatives of the silicic acid. We know the silicic acid, that is tetrahydroxysilicon, that is H4SiO4. Whereas some of the hydrogen atoms of the silicic acid are replaced by the metal. As a result, it may be a discrete unit or it may be a shared portion of the oxygen with the other tetrahedrons. Thus, the metal derivatives of silicic acid are said to be the silicates. Silicates have either a discrete SiO4 4-, this is also known as one variety of silicate, or number of such kind of discrete units are connected by sharing an oxygen between them. Such kind of other things are also known as what? Silicates only. Its formation can be done with the metal oxide followed by fusion with the silica. Otherwise, metal carbonate followed by fusion with silica leads to the formation of silicate. For example, sodium carbonate on reaction with silica, fused silica. On fusion, reaction takes place between them and that leads to the formation of Na2SiO3 N-types. It is a polymer. At the ends, it is connected with the sodium atoms to make the end of the link. So therefore, this is Na2SiO3 N times followed by N times of carbon dioxide formation takes place, which is a gas. Entropy increases in this process and that makes the process to occur in the forward direction by making its delta G as negative. It is a non-redox reaction. Thus, silicates can be classified on the basis of the number of oxygen atoms shared between the individual SiO4 4- units. On behalf of that, there are different varieties of the silicates are there and we will go in detail what are the names of the general names of the silicates and what are the finest examples belonging to each particular category and how to get the monomer unit as well as the formula of the molecule with the help of the monomer and what are its names. With these all things in detail, we will discuss. The general presentation of the silicate SiO4 4- is present in such a way that silicon is connected tetrahedrally with the 4 oxygens. Each oxygen atom is holding 1 unit of negative charge. It is 3-dimensional structure. Inexactly, it is present in such a way that 2 are present on the plane, if we assume. Another one connectivity is present towards us and a connectivity is present away from the us. All are connected with the oxygen, that is O-. But here always writing of the 3-dimensional structure will becomes difficult. Hence, we choose a method of representation of the 3-dimensional on the 2-dimensional in such a way. A triangle is written connected with the 3 oxygens. Whereas here the circle, that is oxygen, at the center dot is present. The dot represents the silicon atom. Silicon atom connected with the oxygen having of 1 unit of negative charge, that the same silicon atom connected with the other 3 oxygen atoms. Thus, symbolically, we are representing the 3-dimensional connectivities of the oxygens connected with the silicon in such a way that with a triangle on the plane, on a paper, we are representing a simplest way, but it is the same 3-dimensional silicate only. Thus, this SiO4 4- is present in such a way that silicon is connected with the 4 oxygens, 1, 2, 3, 4. Each oxygen is having 1 unit of negative charge. They are connected with the sigma bond, followed by, if you take any of the 3, 1, 2, 3, every 3 are present in plane. Thus, in SiO4 4-, silicon is connected with the 4 oxygens with the single bonds. And each oxygen is having 1 unit of negative charge. Any 3 connectivities, if you look at, that is present on the plane. 1, 2, 3, this is a plane. Any of the 3, 1, 2, 3, these 3 are also present on the plane. 1, 2, 3, these 3 are on the plane. These 3 are on the plane. Whereas, such kind of 3-dimensional representation, writing followed by polymerization process related assumption becomes difficult. Hence, we are going for a new method of representation. This oxygen dot indicates the silicon atom connected with oxygen. Here one connectivity, remaining 3 connectivities are here, and here this is just like a representation which becomes easy. This is silicate related representation, and once again formation related another one information. as we said, metal oxides, otherwise the metal carbonates, on reaction with the SiO2 under fusion conditions leads to the formation of silicate. Similarly here, sodium carbonate reactions leads to Na4, SiO4, that is four connectivities are connected with the sodium atom. And sometimes what happens is it may undergo polymerization one with other by sharing the oxygen atoms. SiO3 is repeated for n number of times. The ends are connected with the sodium and the sodium, which gives the general representation, that is Na2, SiO3 n times. Such kind of silicate formation is generally possible. Now we will go in detail related to the all different varieties of individual silicates with examples, formulas and the representation. The first variety of the silicates is orthosilicate, which is also known as nesosilicate. Here it is consisting of the discrete unit of SiO4 4-, that is examples for this are zircon, that is zirconium SiO4, similarly phenacite Be2SiO4, and the fosterite Mg2SiO4, and willemite Zn2SiO4. Here zirconium is present in +4 oxidation state, beryllium is present in +2 oxidation state, magnesium is in +2, and the zinc is also +2. Whereas in this particular variety of the silicate, as being it is consisting of discrete unit, there is no common sharing of the oxygen atom of one SiO4 unit with the other. This is very primary fundamental, said to be what? Orthosilicate. Pyrosilicate, which is also known as sorosilicate, disilicate or the Iceland silicate, with a simple meaning that pyro, on heating from the acids, how anhydride formation takes place by connecting the two acids with some common oxygen. In the same way, here also two silicates are connected with a common oxygen, hence it is said to be the pyrosilicate. The structure of pyrosilicate is SiO4 4-2 units. After eliminating one oxygen in the form of O-2, then it leads to the formation of Si2O7 6-. Structure is in such a way that here it is having oxygen minus, oxygen minus, here oxygen minus, oxygen minus, here also oxygen minus and oxygen minus, that is Si2O7. Here it is not having any charge, so therefore here Si2O7 6- is the charge present over the pyrosilicate. Whereas examples for the pyrosilicate, thortivitite, that is scandium 2 Si2O7, similarly hemimorphite, that is Zn3 Si2O7 followed by zinc hydroxide H2O. We can write it as Zn4OH2 Si2O7 H2O also. Here scandium is present in +3 oxidation state, here zinc is present in +4 oxidation state, so 2, 3, 6 Si2O7. Next one is third one, that is cyclic silicates. Cyclic silicates are formed, a cyclic system is formed by the silicate units, whereas it may be consisting either 3 SiO4 units, otherwise the 6 SiO4 units combination. Whereas the general formula for the 3, see here 3 oxygen atoms are shared. So therefore, the monomeric unit is consisting in such a way that, see the monomeric unit, here this part, if I consider the part of monomeric, it is enough. See, this part is repeated, it belongs to this and it belongs to this, that's what I chosen this one. It is consisting of one silicon, one oxygen compulsory, second oxygen, third oxygen, SiO3, followed by how many units of negative charge it is consisting. Here one oxygen is having negative charge, here also one oxygen is having negative charge. So therefore SiO3 n times, if it is present and it is having a charge of 2n times, that is SiO3n with the negative charge of -2n is the general formula. This may be consisting a cyclic ring of 3 or cyclic ring of 6 also. Everywhere that n stands for number of silicons, 1, 2, 3, minimum 6, 3, 6, such kind of combination is present. Generally available are n is equal to 3 as well as n is equal to 6. These are said to be the cyclic silicates. Cyclic silicates, once again, these are formed by the silicates, maybe 3 silicons, otherwise the 6 silicons combination, having general formula as SiO3 n with a charge of -2n, whereas that N stands for number of silicons present for the cyclic system. Generally, it may be consisting either three rings or the three silicon atoms for the ring, otherwise the six silicon atoms for the ring. We have examples, beryl, Be3Al2SiO3, 6, that is 6 and 10. 6 stands for it is having 12 units of negative charge, whereas that is counterbalanced by 3 beryliums offering 6 units and the 2 aluminiums offering once again 6 units, 6 plus 6, 12. Similarly, benitotite, this is barium titanium SiO3 3 times, it is having total charge of 6, whereas it is counterbalanced by barium of 2 and titanium of 4. Similarly, wollastonite Ca3SiO3 thrice, it is having total charge of 6, is balanced by the 3 calciums of 6. Similarly, information related to the beryl as well as the emeralds are, beryl and emeralds are both are acting as gemstones. Beryl forms the pale green in color, whereas emerald is having dark green in colors, because here some of the atoms of the barium are replaced by the chromium. Emerald has same formula as the beryl, except 1 or 2% of chromium is present by replacing some other atom, that is beryllium. So therefore it is offering the dark green color, and these are said to be what? Emeralds. Thus, cyclic silicates, cyclic silicate related examples and corresponding uses in the form of the emeralds as well as the beryls, pale green color as well as the dark green colors combinations are like this. Yes, single chain silicates, these are also said to be the pyrozines. Whereas it is open form of the cyclic silicates, there is no connectivity from one end to other end, it is open for the both ends. It is extended from one end to other end after opening the ring. Whereas it is also formed by the same sharing of the two oxygen atoms on two corners of the tetrahedron. It is formed by the sharing of two oxygen atoms on adjacent two corners of the tetrahedrons. So therefore it is having the general formula for the representation. See, the repeating unit is like this: silicon followed by one oxygen, second oxygen, third oxygen is common, followed by holding of two units of negative charge, similar to that of the cyclic silicones, cyclic silicates, that is SiO3 N and 2 N minus. Whereas examples for this category are spodumene, that is lithium aluminium SiO3 twice, having total units of 4 charge, counterbalanced by lithium plus 1 and aluminium 3 plus. Similarly, deposite, calcium magnesium SiO3 twice, 4 units of negative charge is balanced by calcium of 2 and the magnesium of other 2. Double chain silicates, these are also known as amphiboles, in which what happens is one chain, already we looked at the examples, and the other chain, both are connected with one another. Thus, in which what happens is some of the silicates are connected with the two oxygen atoms by sharing, and the other, some of the silicates are connected by sharing of the three oxygen atoms with the others. Thus, one chain followed by other chain, double chain silicates are formed. Let us go for the structural features of the double chain silicates. This is a single chain, a line followed by one silicate, other silicate at the top, bottom, top and bottom. Similarly, the other silicate connecting bottom with the top, and also bottom of this one, top one with the top of bottom one, bottom of top one with the top of bottom one. Whereas in this, the repeating unit is, see here, the dotted square type of box is there. In that, whatever the silicates are there, those are the repeating monomeric unit. Here it is consisting of one oxygen, silicon. Here is oxygen, here is oxygen, here is oxygen and the silicon. Whereas here oxygen and silicon, oxygen, oxygen, oxygen is there, oxygen and silicon is there, oxygen. Here 1, 2, 3, 4 silicons are there, that is Si4. Oxygens, let us count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 oxygens are there. That is Si4O11, followed by, suppose if it repeats one time, then how much of charge is present? See here, this oxygen is having 1 unit negative, 1 unit negative, 2, 3 and 4, followed by 5 as well as the 6, 6 units of negative charge is there. For 1, it is having 6 units of negative charge, so therefore this is Si4O11, N of 6 and minus. Amphiboles are always contains the hydroxide groups attached to the metal ions. They never present in the free state, and some of the metal ions always consisting of OH in connectivity with their let us go for the examples of the amphiboles. Yes, let us go for the examples of the amphiboles, that is primolite having formula Ca2Mg5Si4O11 twice followed by OH twice. As we know, this is Si4O11, every one unit is having 6 units of negative charge. Here 2 units are there, then it is having total 12 units of negative charge. Let us count the positive charge, 2 calciums 4 and the 5 magnesiums 10, 14 is there, another 2 is balanced by the 2 OH minus. Similarly, prosodolite Na2, Fe3 and Fe2 oxidation states of 3 and 2 followed by SiO4 2 times of OH twice. 2 times implies minus 12, we need plus 12. Let us count. This is 2 units, whereas here 3 units followed by 3 are there. 3 units followed by 3 implies here it is 9, and 2 units followed by 2 implies this is 4, 13, 13 plus, once again here sodium is offering plus 1, and here the number of sodiums are 2 units. Yes, on counting the charge, 2 units of sodium is offering plus 2, whereas Fe plus 2 of 3, that is 6, whereas ferrous plus 3 of 2 implies once again 6. Total is here 14 is there, but we need only 12, and remaining 2 are counterbalanced by the 2 OHs. Thus here prosodolite and the primolite are examples for the amphiboles, are said to be the double chain silicates. Two-dimensional sheet-like silicates which are also said to be the pyrosilicates. Here 3 oxygen atoms for each silicate are shared with the other silicates, whereas if I go for the structure related to the two-dimensional, here this is silicate, ups and down silicates are present, and in order to extend in the form of a sheet, here line is a double line is extended once again like this. The sheet is formed from one end to other end of the plane. Here the repeating unit, if I look at here, this particular portion is acting as a repeating unit. This is not, I am not considering, though this is a common portion, I am not considering this one. The next portion is considered over here also. This portion is not considered, this portion and this portion both are common, hence as being it is not considered, half went away. For this half, on considering here, it is considered as a considerable extent in the formula, monomeric formula of the two-dimensional sheet-like silicate. Here this is oxygen, whereas in our consideration, and this is oxygen, whereas two silicon atoms are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 oxygen atoms are there, Si2O5 followed by negative charges present, one is over here, one is over here. So therefore every monomeric unit Si2O5 is consisting 2 units of negative charge, hence the formula is Si2O5N with the power of minus 2n is the formula. Whereas examples are talc, that is soapstone is an example, and also choline is also an example, that is soapstone consisting of formula Mg3OH2SiO2 twice. SiO2 twice implies it is having charge of minus 4, and 2 OHs are offering another minus 2, total is of minus 6, minus 6 is balanced by 3 magnesiums. Similarly here choline, that is Al2OH4Si2O5, Si2O5 is offering minus 2, and here once again minus 4, total is minus 6. Minus 6 is counterbalanced by a charge of plus 6 offered by 2 aluminiums, of each aluminium is having of plus 3 units of positive charge. Thus these silicates are said to be the two dimensional silicates having the repeating unit formula is Si2O5N with a charge of minus 2N. Three-dimensional silicate, here it is formed by sharing of the all oxygen atoms, that is 4 oxygen atoms with the other tetrahedral SiO4 units. SiO2 is the formula representation, because in this repetition, here if I take one silicon atom as my representation, here this portion is considered as the empirical formula, that is SiO2, having examples like quartz, tridymite, crystoballite, etc., and other examples related to the three-dimensional modifications are along with the quartz, feldspar, geolite and the ultramarines are examples. Let us have a small discussion over the feldspar, geolite as well as the ultramarine. Feldspars, These are also known as potassium aluminium silicates, barium aluminium silicates, calcium aluminium silicate, and some sodium aluminium silicates are generally said to be the feldspars. In this, what happens is the three-dimensional silicate SiO4 four minus units are there, whereas some of the silicate atoms are replaced by the aluminium, and it is connected with the four oxygen atoms, but it is maintaining valency of +3. Hence, that one unit of extra negative charge is counterbalanced by +1 unit of positive charge. So therefore, here aluminium 3 plus potassium plus 1, total 4 is considered as another one silicon. So therefore, here 3 silicons plus 1 silicon, that is 4 silicons. Every silicon is having 2 oxygens, 4 silicon, 4 into 2, 8. So therefore, here the formula is, here 1 silicon plus 1 silicon, 2 silicons are there, that is 3 plus 1, 4 silicons are there. 4 silicons in place. Here the formula for the potassium aluminium silicate is, hence the formula is, here another one unit of silicon, so 3 plus 1, 4 silicons, 4 silicons in place, 8 oxygens, that is Si2O8 potassium aluminium Si3O8. Similarly, here some of the silicons are replaced by aluminium, whereas aluminium relevant charge 2 aluminiums is having extra deficiency of the 2 units of positive charge is balanced by barium. So therefore, total this is 6 plus 2, 8 implies another 2 silicons, 2 plus 2, 4, Si4O8 leads with the empirical formula, that is SiO2 of the silica. Similarly, aluminium calcium silicate, it is also similar to that of the above. Sodium aluminium silicate, 1 sodium, 1 aluminium, total 4 units. 4 units stands for another 1 silicon, 3 plus 1, 4 silicons. So therefore, this is NaAlSi3O8. Zeolites. Zeolites are the hydrated aluminosilicates in which some of the silicon atoms of the silica are replaced by the aluminium, and it is having one unit of positive, that is deficiency of the charge is counterbalanced by either first A group cations or the second A group cations like sodium, potassium, else alkaline earth metals like calcium. So therefore, here some m number of water molecules are there. Suppose SiO2 forms Y and some of the SiO2s are replaced by alumina. The general formula in the three-dimensional network of the silicate type, it is also maintaining 2 atoms for each aluminium. So therefore, Al2X times SiO2Y times. Whereas aluminium is having, can form only 3 bonds, +3 units of charge. It requires another 1 unit of charge, that is counterbalanced by the cations like alkali metals. If I take alkali metals, this is X, whereas if I take alkaline earth metals, this will be X by 2. Such kind of all compounds are said to be what? Zeolites. Some more valid information about the zeolites. Zeolites are having honeycomb like structure. They have more open space in the structure compared to the feldspars. And sodium zeolite is said to be the permit, and which is used for the water softening. And already remaining things like the catalytical activity as well as the ion exchange resin methods, such kind of all properties related to the zeolite are discussed. Ultramarine, it is a special case of lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli is a blue color crystalline compound, whereas it is consisting of complex of silicate of sodium and aluminium with some percentage of sulfur. That particular one is said to be the ultramarine. It belongs to the category of the lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli, if it is consisting aluminium silicate in association with sodium aluminium silicate in association with an anion like S2-2, then that is said to be the ultramarine. If it is consisting of anion like Cl-, then that is said to be sodalite. And if it is consisting anion like sulfate, then that is said to be what? Nocine. Whereas these lapis lazulis, which are blue color crystalline compounds, are not having any kind of water, but they are having anions like S2-2, Cl-1, SO42-. Whereas the formula illustration is a modification towards the silica. Some of the silica atoms in the three-dimensional network structure are replaced by aluminium, but aluminium is not maintaining +4 units of charge, and the remaining charge is counterbalanced by the sodium. And in association, they are having anions like S2-2, Cl- and SO4-, and these are respectively known as ultramarine, sodalite, as well as the nocine. Let us go for the ultramarine formula illustration once. See here, aluminiums, six aluminiums are present. Every aluminium is having lack of 1 unit of charge. So therefore, we need 6 units of positive charge. S2 is present in the form of -2. Here, out of total 8 units of charge, 2 are balanced over here. Remaining six are consumed over here. That is ultramarine. Similarly, soda light. See here, in case of soda light also, same. Here, instead of S2 minus 2, here 2 Cl's are there, every Cl is having 1 unit of negative charge. Similarly, here SO4 minus 2 is there, same formula is maintained, that is Na8AlSiO4, 6 times followed by S2, 2 Cl or SO4. These are said to be the ultramarines, sodalite, as well as the nosine, etc. And these are belongs to the category of the Laplace lazuli, and each one is respectively known, corresponding formula, composition, and the utilities related to the Laplace lazuli.